Hey people, here I am again with my weekly videos. May I ask you guys to subscribe for cool weekly uploads such as this one? Also make sure to leave a like. I put a lot of effort in making these videos weekly, and if we potentially reach enough subscribers, I could maybe be able to earn some money with this. Also let me know in the comments what video you would like to see next. Today we're looking at some super rare LEGO figures. The last one even sells for over $1,100. Whoa. Let's open up our list. On number 20 we have the 1999 Red Sox giveaway, which goes for $100 to $150 right now. This exclusive minifigure featured a red baseball cap, a printed Red Sox logo on the front, and a Lego logo on the back. It was given away to kids attending a Bo Sox game in the summer of 1999. It's unknown how many were produced for the promotion, nor how many survive today, but when they appear on eBay, they regularly sell to diehard fans of Beantown Baseball. A related Red Sox promotion from the same year was a 1-inch by 2-inch Duplo brick with a Red Sox and Legos printed on each side. Today, this tiny little brick will fetch $100 and it's if it's in a good shape. Number 19 is a 2012 San Diego Comic-Con superheroes. They sell for $150 to about $185 each. As one of the biggest genre entertainment conventions in the world, it's no surprise that LEGO pulls out all the stops for San Diego Comic-Con in 2012. They offer a series of 4 superhero minifigures, each with a limited production run of only 1,000 pieces as a special giveaway. The heroes, DC Comics Shazam and Bizarro, and Marvel Comics Venom and Phoenix were displayed on specially marked cars that resembled comic book covers, along with a small brick to help the future stand. The figure stand, I mean. Naturally, you'll only get top dollar on the resale market if you keep the brick and cars. 18 is the Cloud City Boba Fett. It sells for $150 to $185. The Enigmatic Bounty Hunter Boba Fett is one of the most popular characters in the Star Wars universe, and he's also one of the most popular minifigures. Fett was first seen in LEGO form in 2000 as part of the Slave I Placed, or Slave 1 Placed, I think it is, yes, and has been featured in multiple sets since. However, the Fett found in 2003's Cloud City playset is one of the most collectible. The figure was an update to the initial model and is one of the few minifigs with printed designs on the arms and legs. Number 17 is the 2012 San Diego Comic-Con Biblo Baggins, which goes for about $150 to $200. One of the most fun promotions LEGO has offered has been the Build a Biblo event, 2012 San Diego Comic-Con, to tie in with the release of The Hobbit, An Unexpected Journey. After first stopping by the LEGO booth to pick up a specially tagged burlap pouch, a piece of minifigure hair, and a map of Comic Condor, you then followed the map to other Hobbit related booths to collect various parts of the figure. If you completed your quest, you'd have a Bilbo minifig exactly like the one released later in a Hobbit LEGO set, but if you kept that burlap sack in a map of Comic Gunner, suddenly that everyday minifig is worth a whole lot more. On number 16 we have the New York I Love Yoda Times Square Toys R Us exclusive, which goes for $200 to $250. If you were lucky enough to be in the New York City's Times Square in late May last year, you were able to see a life-sized X-Wing fighter made entirely out of LEGO bricks. To celebrate, the nearby Toys R Us window offered an exclusive Yoda minifig with the purchase of an X-Wing playset. Unlike most Yoda minifigs, this one was limited to only 1,000 pieces, and instead of his usual Jedi robes, this diminutive master is wearing an iconic I Love New York shirt. Well, sort of. In Yoda speak, it's New York I Love. 15 is the 2011 San Diego Comic-Con Green Lantern and Batman, which sell for $225 to $250 each. In 2011, lucky Comic-Con attendees could win the very first minifig of DC Comics Green Lantern. The figure was presented on a card made to look like a copy of the fictional San Diego Brick newspaper, with the headline Superheroes Unite, emblazoned across the top. Obviously, if you want to get top dollar for your Green Lantern minifig on eBay now, you'd better have that card. At the same con, Batman minifigs were also given away on a similar newspaper presentation, although it wasn't the first time the Dark Knight has been seen in Lego's, wow, I can't speak today, sorry. He's been a staple character since 2006. It was an updated version of the figure with a more detailed print of his costume. The previous one is actually 15 and 14, and this one is 13 and 12. The 2012 New York Comic Con Shadow Leonardo, which goes for $250 to around $350, and Battle Damaged Krang, which goes for around $100. To celebrate their new line of Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle playsets, LEGO offered an exclusive Dark Leonardo, some call him Shadow Leo, minifig at New York's Comic-Con in 2012. The figure, completely black and grey except for his brown turtle shell and famous blue mask, came with a special NYGG skateboard for surfing through the sewers of the Big Apple. Not many of the approximately 500 Dark Leonardo figures have hit the market just yet, but some have sold for as little as $225, while others have topped out at $350. Meanwhile, in another part of the city, people showed up at the Rockefeller Center, the LEGO store, dressed as their favorite mutant turtle in order to get their hands on an exclusive minifig, the Battle Damaged Krang. Only 300 Krangs were made, and today they sell pretty regularly for about $100 on eBay. Here we have another double one for some reason, number 11 and number 10, which are the 2013 San Diego Comic-Con Green Arrow and Superman, which sell for $300 to $350 each. LEGO gave away even more superheroic minifigures at last year's Comic-Con. Oh, it says last year's Comic-Con. Okay, this list is very old, apparently. This time around, they had a hooded Green Arrow, and black and silver Superman modeled after the costume featured in the film Man of Steel. Both figures came inside a rigid plastic case with a background showing a city in peril and were limited to only 200 pieces each, making them pretty rare today. Here we have another double one for some reason. The list makers added a lot of double ones. This is number 9 and number 8. The 2013 San Diego Comic-Con Spider-Man and Spider-Woman, which sell for $325 to $370 each. As you can see, there's a lot of Comic-Con figures. So similar to their DC Comics counterparts, Spider-Man and Spider-Woman also got the SDGG exclusive treatment last year. Oddly enough, there are more of these figures out there, $325 of each. But they actually sell for a slightly higher price. You can't underestimate the popularity of friendly neighborhood wall crawler. Number 7 is finally not a double one. It's a gold chrome plated C-3PO, which sells for $350 to about $450. In 2007, to celebrate the 30th anniversary of Star Wars, everyone's favorite protocol droid got a bit of an upgrade. LEGO randomly added a gold chrome plated C-3PO minifig to 10,000 Star Wars playsets. The figures were sealed in opaque with white plastic bags, but a smart collector left the bag closed and can now sell the contest for hundreds of dollars on eBay, sight unseen. Number 6 is the 2011 New York Comic Con Superman, which sells for about $400. The Man of Steel made his minifig debut at New York Comic Con in 2011, alongside additional copies of the Green Lantern and Batman minifigs from that year's San Diego Comic-Con. Superman was presented with the same newspaper-style cardboard backing as the other two heroes, but there were only 200 figures available. Because Supes was so scarce, because Supes was so scarce, he demands a top price today. I have no idea if I said it right. At number 5, we have the 2013 San Diego Comic-Con Azog, which sells for about $500, so another Comic-Con one. At 2013 San Diego Comic-Con, LEGO employees wandered the con floor and handed out the figures to random passerby. Passersby, sorry. This Aesop minifig is exactly the same as the one included in retail Hobbit places, but this one is packaged in a plastic container with a cardboard background that features the Comic-Con logo. Boom, instant collector's item. On number 4 we have this very rare one, the International Space Station Alien, which sells for about $600. Between April 30th and May 6th, 2001, 300 alien minifigs from the short-lived Life on Mars line of LEGO toys were sent into orbit on the International Space Station. After returning to Earth, the figures were framed with a certificate of authenticity and handed out to attendees at a special ceremony held by LEGO and NASA, making them a rare collector's item today. After all, not everyone can say that they have a minifigure that's actually been to space. Here is another double one, and number 3 and number 2 are the 2012 Toy Fair icon Iron Man and Captain America, which sell for about $950 to $1,125 combined. At LEGO's exclusive collector's preview party during Toy Fair 2012, the company handed out 125 special edition minifigs of Marvel's comics Iron Man and Captain America. Instead of being modeled after the movie characters that were available in superhero playsets, these minifigs were modeled after the then current comic book versions of the characters. The Captain America figure has black arms and legs similar to the modified costume worn by Bucky Barnes when he took over as a patriotic crime fighter after the original Cap, Steve Rogers, was killed. The defining feature of Iron Man figure is the normal sized minifig head with a printed on helmet. In the playsets, the Iron Man figure has an oversized removable mask so you can see Tony Stark's snarky smirk underneath. The minifigs came packaged together and most collectors refuse to break up the set, so if you want to get your hands on one or the other, you'll usually have to buy them together. A few Wise Toys Fair attendees have even included the badge and promotional flyer for the preview party in their auctions, helping to push the final price to between $1,500 and $2,000. And then we have our number 1, which is the Series 10 Mr. Gold exclusive, which sells for $500 to $1,100. In 2010, recognizing how popular their little figures had become, LEGO introduced a set of 16 collectible minifigs, sealed in opaque plastic bags so no one could tell what figure was inside. The new minifigs included a caveman, a ninja, a robot and a nurse. Since then, the new minifig series have been released every year. Series 10, released in 2013, featured an exclusive gold chrome-plated figure known as Mr. Gold. This top hat and monocle wearing jewel-topped king-carrying figure became the mascot of the series, limited to only 5,000 pieces worldwide. It has since become the single most expensive minifig on the market today. Prices vary widely, ranging anywhere from $500 to $1,100, so it really comes down to how much you need to complete your Series 10 minifig collection and how much you're willing to spend on it. Thank you very much for watching. We upload every Wednesday a new video. You can vote for which video you want to see next week. Just leave a comment and then we can pick that video. Make sure to like and subscribe. Also join our Discord server in the description. And I'll see you guys in the next one.